Here's a little bit of my thoughts about the first aid kits. Something I want to share with you guys. For me, I think first aid kits need to be available. One, available, which means they need to be easily identifiable. You should be able to walk into the area and see, oh, that Red Cross, hey, that's first aid right over there. If you can have the best first aid kit in the world, but if it's hidden underneath some sink or something and people can't find it and people in your house don't know where it's at, then you're pretty much screwed. Okay. Second thing I like with my first aid kit is to have more than it really necessarily needs. You want to have more band-aids, more of that stuff than you think you're going to need, because you may end up using it one time and then something else happens, then something else may happen. You may not have time to replenish it and replace items that you use. Something like that could really happen in a disaster, an SATF. All right, number three, you gotta have organization. If it's not well organized, it doesn't really matter that much, because it can take more time for you to utilize what you actually have if you gotta look through everything. So you need to know where everything's at. Okay, let's look at this first aid kit. This isn't one I put together, but this is one that's just in this building. All right, off the bat, organization. I don't like the fact that things are falling out when you open it up. It needs to be more organized. You can tell that it's very dated. So I might have to replace some of this stuff, but these are some wipes right here. These are some antiseptics, wipes for really cleaning. There's a first aid book, which is really important when you're gonna have a first aid kit. What else? Some pads. I like to have a lot more than this. There's an iPad. There's another pad right here. This is all it really has. That's not really good enough, really. Okay, these are blue finger cots. Okay, this is a good ABD pad, which I don't know a lot about, but I gotta learn more about it. Triple antibiotic ointment. I love the fact that when you open this up, there's little packets instead of just having one tube, you know, just for sanitary reasons. It's pretty good. Triangular bandage with safety pins. Really good thing to have in there as well. And, you know, this is, what exactly is this? Oh, just rubber gloves, latex gloves, I should say. You know, and there's a cold pack right here in case somebody strain a muscle or something. So, that means nothing spectacular, but I guess it's better than nothing. I have my own, wherever I go, I have one in a vehicle that I put together. And I also have one in the home, or the apartment, or wherever the location I'm at, which I live. So anyway, let's take a look at what I have in my van. Okay, I added an Israeli emergency bandage, which is really good, especially for wounds on the arms. Obviously, you can see the different pads I have. I have a lot of sterile padding and dressing in here. I have the triple antibiotic ointment plus pain relief. And I have a lot of wipes in here as well. First aid burn cream. Also added an additional bandage right here. Have a lot of the bandages and extra pads I got from the dollar store back here. So you see in here, there's plenty of this stuff in here. It's not just one or two. You want to have plenty. And I also have that instant cold compress in case somebody hurts their leg or something. Again, more. Band-aids, of course, easy to find. And the thing I like about this setup, there's a little tape right there. I'm actually going to add another tape to it. I actually bought some tape. This isn't really enough. You're going to need more than this. I'm going to add more of that. And I want to sort of focus on not only having the pads, but having the tape to actually secure the stuff. Secure it. Now, let me grab some stuff. For the vehicle. Okay. You guys know about the sterile pads. I have a lot of these extra ones in the house as well. These are sterile surgery pads. More pads, compressed pads, compression pads. Plenty. You always want to have more than you think you would need, even though it's only one person here. One person in the vehicle. I typically only have one person in the vehicle. You gotta also prep for other people as well. Something may happen. Ankle support. I used to have like a knee support little band on there as well. I have to get another one next time I go to the dollar store. Cayenne pepper, supposedly really good for stopping bleeding under certain situations. Emergency blanket, which I incorporated into here. Even threw in some cheap batteries I got from, Harbor Freight. Some foot relief. Not really emergency first aid stuff, but you know, it could be really comfortable. Really important stuff. Little things can matter in a bad situation. Wet wipes. You know, obviously I don't have any children, but who knows? You know, a little poncho. I already have a real poncho right here. But if there's another person with me, it's a little Advil. Not a lot. More pain relief. But this just gives you options. Also, this is the official first aid kit I put together. I've shown a lot of you guys. A lot of people think that this quick clot sport is just some powder. It's not. If you actually look at it, it's a sponge, if you read it carefully. It's not the old school quick clot that a lot of you guys are familiar with. There's some alcohol pads. There's also some big band-aids. I like having big band-aids, okay? Let me show you that right there. Really big band-aids to cover areas. You never know what type of cut you're gonna have. This is waterproof tape. I definitely recommend waterproof tape. You guys have seen the stuff that's already in here, but now just to give you an idea of some of the stuff I like to get into. Now, is that good enough just to have firearms? You gotta have other things as well.